So in this question it all that Savannah Fruit Processors Limited produces mango juice. The mangoes are purchased directly from farmers. Okay. Then you're given information about transactions between July and December 2012. And you are asked to confirm the accuracy of the VAT reported by Savannah Fruit Processors Limited between August 2012 and December 2012. Now, the key thing to remember here is that VAT is normally reported in the subsequent month. So if you are looking for the number that was reported in December, means it was the November VAT. So in other words, we are being asked to only look up to November. Okay, because the November figures are the ones that are going to be reported in the month of December. Great. So we are told that the sales were for 50,000. The sales increased by 5% in August and by 10% per month in the subsequent months. Okay. Then you're told that the monthly purchases from farmers were constant at 180. Then what we actually paid as VAT was 217,500, and we had claimed input tax of 45. So let's confirm whether that number is accurate. So the first thing we have to do is we need to determine what the output VAT is. So let's see. What is the output VAT on the sales? So we have the period of July, August, September, October, and November. And you told that the sales were how much? Sales in July were 450. They increased by 5% in August and 10% thereafter. So in July, the amount was 450. In August, they increased by 5%. So it became 105% or 1.05 times 450, which basically gives you 472,500. Thereafter, they started going up by 10%. So meaning that here we had 110% of 472,500, which gives you 519,750. In October, we had 110% of 519,750, which gives you 571,725. In November, we had 110% of 571,725, which gave you 628,898. So the total sales we had were 2642,873. So the question is, this is the sales. So the question is, what was the output VAT? So the VAT will be 16% times 2642,873, which basically gives you 422,860. Okay, great. Now that we know that, let's look at the input VAT. On the input VAT side, we are told that the monthly purchases from farmers were constant at 180,000 per month. So the key thing is to work with the assumption that your average peasant farmer is not VAT registered. It therefore follows that if they're not VAT registered, means that they don't charge you VAT, and therefore there is no input VAT on purchases. Okay. However, the entity may have gotten input VAT on other separate items, and that's why we are told that the input tax claimed amounted to 45,000. So probably they had other things, fuel, etc., which already had VAT, and they were able to claim 45,000. So we're going to assume that that 45,000 is not under dispute. It therefore means that our tax payable should be determined as being output VAT, which you have gotten as being 422,860. Then we less input VAT that was claimed, so to give us the liability, this is what was payable. So, but what was the actual amount that was paid? We are told that the value added tax paid was 217,500. So he paid less. So if he less the actual payment, we are able to get that we had an underpayment of VAT. And the underpayment is 160,360. What was the question asking? Confirm the accuracy of the VAT reported. So we can just make a note that the VAT is understated by 160,360. And that is all that the examiner expected of us in this question.